Assalamualaikum, my name is Widi Mutakin. This is part 7 of the video tutorial series. In case you stumble upon this video directly, be sure to check out the previous videos before moving on. The tutorial series is about developing augmented reality product from A to Z using Blender, Unity, and Vuforia. These tutorials are all based on my previous experience developing my own augmented reality product, which is this flashcard Arabic letters and numbers augmented reality. Basically, a flashcard to help children learning Arabic alphabet using augmented reality. I leave links below in the description if you like to learn more or purchase the flashcards from Amazon. In this video, we'll be focusing on creating the animation. First, let's set up our scene so it's better suited for creating animation. For animation, we need at least two windows or panels open. One is timeline, which we have in here already open. The other one is drop sheet panel. So let's just drag the top corner of the timeline to create a new panel. Then change the panel type to drop sheet. We actually don't need to see the timeline view, only the header. So we can drag this down until the header of the drop sheet attach to the timeline header. Okay, now let's go to frame 1. In this frame, we want to record the pose of Carney in keyframes. First, select the armature. Make sure you are in pose mode. And to reset all of the bone transformation to its original, first press A to select all of them. Then press Alt-G to reset their position. Then we press Alt-R to rest their rotation as well. So again, I repeat, press Alt-G will reset position of the bones. Press Alt-R to reset its rotation. We never use scale on the bones, but in case you want to reset the scale also, you can press Alt-S to do that. Now while doing animation, mostly we only want to select the bone, not the actual skin object. We can make the skin object to be unselectable by first selecting it, and in the outliner, expand the armature object. Find Carney 3D model, then click on this arrow icon, which is basically will avoid Carney 3D model from being selected. Okay, now go to side view by pressing 3, and let's make the body of the trunk posing like letter S. Pick this bone, rotate it like so. Select the child bone by right clicking on it or by pressing closing bracket. Rotate again, then the next child also. Okay, let's make the mouth a bit closed. Okay, now we want to save this pose as keyframes. To do that, we can select all of the bones by pressing A, then press I. I keyboard shortcut is for inserting keyframes. Because it will work only on selected object, therefore you should already select the whole bones before pressing I, okay? Very important. Okay, when we press I, Blender gives us so many options of what you want to save to keyframes. There are actually more things that Blender can keyframe, but that will be outside the scope of our tutorial. Okay, now we want to save the movement and the rotation of each of the selected bones. So the fastest way to do this is to select Lock Rot, which stands for Location and Rotation. Now as you can see, every bones we selected will be recorded in a form of keyframes in here, in terms of the position and the rotation values. Now, these bones are officially animated bones. What this means, when in animated mode, every time you make changes to the rotation or the position of the bone, it will always snap back to the previous pose defined by the keyframes. If you need to make the transformational changes become permanent, you need to insert keyframes again at that frame location. Another way to add keyframes is to turn on this button down here, Automatic Keyframe Insertion. If this button is on, whenever you move to a certain frame and do any transformational changes, those changes will be recorded as keyframes automatically. So for example, let's create a breathing sequence 2 times for Carney. Move the slider to frame 20, then rotate this bone a bit. Then this one. This one also. Finally, the head bone. Notice when we make changes, these keyframes created automatically. If we scrub the drop sheet, we have a breathe in animation. Okay, now to create the breathe out animation, we simply need to copy the pose in frame 1 and then paste them in frame 40. We can do this in several ways. Here is one way to do it. Go to frame 1, move the mouse on the 3D view, press A to select all of the bones, press Ctrl C to copy pose. Remember, when you do this, you need to move your mouse on the 3D view, not in a dob sheet. This is because Blender shortcut system is very dependent on where your mouse cursor is located. Okay, now move the playhead to frame 40. Again, move the mouse on the 3D view, not on the dob sheet, and then press Ctrl V. As you can see, the pose from frame 1 copied to frame 40, and the keyframes automatically generated at that frame. Now we have breathing in and breathing out animation. Another way to copy-paste frames is by using Shift-D inside the dob sheet. To see how this can be done, first let's select these two columns of keyframes, which are in frame 20 and frame 40. To do this, we can press B to use box selection and click drag like this. Now these two columns of keyframes are all selected. Besides using box selection to select multiple columns of keyframes, you can also use the master keyframes up here, or also known as summary keyframes. To show you how this works, let me press A first to unselect everything. Okay, if we right click on this summary keyframe, it will select the whole column of keyframes below it, which is nice. To select another column, simply press and hold Shift and right click on another summary keyframes, which is this one. Okay, after we have these two columns selected, we can use Shift D and then move these new copied keyframes about 20 frames forward from the last keyframes, so it should be at frame 60. I think that's pretty much cover the basic techniques of creating animation. For the rest, I will speed up the video as there is nothing new to discuss. You can create any type of animation as you please from this current step. For me, I'm going to create a biting animation from frame 80 to frame 130. Okay guys, we now have something like this. Save the file with incremental number by pressing Ctrl-Shift-S and then press plus in the numpad, then enter. In this way, we have backup for our previous file. This is important in case we want to go back, undo some changes, and also for backups. In the next video, we're going to cover importing this model to Unity and adding Vuforia engine and publish our augmented reality app, inshallah. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Wassalamualaikum.